Angles on parallel lines. Standard level 6 grade D GCSE question. Really simple setup, two parallel lines. We should know three types of things that help us with parallel lines. There's the Z shape, where the angles on the inside of the Z are the same. That can be either on that, or it can be on the sort of elongated S type Z, so these two angles are the same. Now we need to know the definition of this. This is the one used in here. These are called alternate angles, and is now on GCSE Maths exams currently you have to name the correct terminology. So the reason here would be alternate angles, or alternate angles are the same, are equal, and you need to state 68. Most people can get it 68. It looks like it's 68, but you've got to get the alternate angles are equal. It's one mark for that and one mark for that, and you'd be kicking yourself if that one mark was the one that stopped you from getting the next grade up. The other two that you need to know as well are corresponding angles, where the angles are underneath like this. So these angles correspond with each other, they're in the same position, and that can be a backwards F, it could be upside down F, so it's the F shape is the corresponding angles, they're the same. And the other one has many names. Some people like to call them supplementary angles because they add up to 180, but the word they're looking for these days is interior, because they're on the inside. Interior angles add to 180 degrees. So you must use these words: interior, corresponding, alternate. You can't use the shape to describe it, as we used to be able to do. This used to be called a C angle, F angle, and Z angles. But we need to know these three words to get the extra mark, and that could be the difference between an A and an A star.